shooting at the 111 Club. 6232 Hollywood Boulevard.
Sounds like a homicide beef.
Two of the dead guys caught in the crossfire were carrying army surplus morphine. Get over there before homicide tramples all over the place.
We already cleared that up.
Judge in Pasadena took the big sleep yesterday. He had a personal stash of 20 cigarettes. Appears we didn't get all of it.
We can't seem to put this morphine to sleep. A dead judge. It's not good.
Everyone has their vices. Even you, Phelps.
That bum took a swipe at me. Put him down with my sap.
They shoot a red light that you never saw.
What a skunk.
Can you drive to this
down
one?
On his wife like that.
Parker and Green are going toe-to-toe for the top job. There's a change in the wind.
About time.
This wind will be like a tornado, Phelps. Parker's got a puritanical streak. You never know we'll get swept up in a thing like that.
Homicide guys are already inside.
Bukowski.
Phelps. Back again.
We're here about the morphine.
Over by the bandstand. You can see what's left of the owner, Eddie McGoldrick, 26, former Marine.
I know Eddie McGoldrick. He was a non-com in my old unit.
I'm sorry to hear that, Cole. Waitress said he recently came into some money and bought the club.
Who are the other Vicks?
Two musicians, Biddleston and Bo. And get this, they used to be in a four-piece, but the trombone player and the drummer OD'd.
Don't tell me. Lamont and Tyree? We've met the rest of the band.
Now they're a no-piece.
Do you mind if we take a look around?
Be my guest. You might want a word with the hostess, too. I'll keep her company until you're ready.
Must have pumped a dozen rounds into him. Certainly sends a message.
When you're ready to have a civil conversation, we can try again.
Find anything interesting?
Well maintained. Custom case. Someone cared for this instrument.
Seen it all.
Neat trick. The case must have cost more than the trumpet. We should follow up on the musician angle. He kept his stash close at hand. We have a new source, or is this coming from what's left in circulation? A dozen packs to a carton, 100 cartons or more, looks like a couple of months' supply. Ma'am, I'm Detective Phelps, Administrative Vice Squad.
Welcome to the 111 Club, Detective. Feels like I've had half the LAPD in here today already.
Any idea who did the shooting?
No idea. It was my day off. If I had been here, honey, I'd be full of holes just like the others.
You want to level with me, miss, before we start taking an interest in you?
This place has been on the slide for years. Eddie turns up, buys the club, then we start getting visits from tough guys. Next thing you know, we have the St. Valentine's Day Massacre. Are you getting the picture?
Tell us about Eddie.
Eddie didn't know a thing about running a nightclub. He came into some money and waltzed in and bought the place. The previous owner thought all his Christmases had come at once.
Where do you think he got the money?
My guess was that he was selling the sort of quality product that you don't need to advertise.
Thank you for your help, ma'am.
Eddie was in over his head, but he was a decent boss.
Never the same, are they?
And I thought this was such a nice area. All these
cops. You drive. I need to go over the case notes.
All right, where to? That cherry pie was delicious.
Take a break, boys.
We would like them to stay, Miss Lichtman. We're making inquiries into the recent deaths of four musicians.
Since when have the police cared about dead black men?
Good point. We don't. What we care about is 2 tons of Army surplus morphine showing up on the street. If you care about working in this town, you better give me something on Biddleston and Beau, or their knucklehead buddies, Tyree and Lamont.
And this is your idea of making inquiries, understand Fuhrer?
I've told you 1,000 times about speaking that German gibberish at me, Elsa.
Roy! How about you get a drink while I see to this?
Will you sit down?
Why antagonize him, Elsa? You know what he's capable of.
Ask your questions, head officer. We have work to do.
People are dying of overdoses. If you know anything about it, you need to tell me.
I can't help you.
A lot of cats are into the thing. There's nothing special about your boys.
You can do this the easy way with me, or I can call my partner back over. I can assure you he's a lot less sensitive.
You think your threats frighten me?
Black man don't supply nothing. You think there's a black man in this town holding on to 2 tons of morphine? He'd be dead in a minute. White man supplies, black man buys.
My partner mentioned a couple of names. You recognize them?
I have no idea what you're talking about.
The only way you're going to get rid of me is to give me an answer.
I knew Cornell. We worked together a few years ago. He loved the music, but the music didn't love him.
What does that mean?
It means that he just wasn't that good. He was a sad, lonely cat.
Boys, take 5 minutes, please. I need to have a private word with the officer. Why do you ask people to risk talking about a subject that could have them jailed?
Drugs are against the law, Elsa.
And you're so full of courage, you have never felt ashamed.
This is getting us nowhere.
Do you think you'll win your war against narcotics?
It's not my war. It's against the law. My job is to prosecute the laws of this city.
Do you think you can stop people from needing drugs, detective?
I'm asking the questions here.
Then why do you come to me with your stupid questions? You know who controls the drugs in this city.
It's not enough to just survive, Elsa. You have to try and make the world a better place.
Brave words and very noble. But words are just words, Cole Phelps.
She's right. We need to pay a visit to the Mixter.
Cohen? Do you know where to find him?
This time of day? You'll find him holding court at the Macambo.
He can wait. There's something I need to be sure of. Give me till tomorrow morning.
Don't do anything I wouldn't do, partner.
Risk losing the trail.
LAPD, we're looking for Mayor Cohen. I believe he has lunch here.
There's not going to be any trouble, is there?
Which table?
Number three, if you'll follow me.
Goddamn Harry thinks he can get fresh whenever he pleases.
Waitress, Could I get another spoon?
LAPD, we have some questions.
Hi,
regarding...
Mickey. How's it hanging?
Fine. Just fine, Roy. I see you brought Igabiva along. Hope he's not going to put the shakes on me again.
Cole Phelps. Mickey Cohen.
Good afternoon.
He has manners. Aren't you a little green for this kid?
Meet Johnny Stompanato, Cole. He has the biggest schlong in Hollywood and the smallest gun. Or maybe that's the other way around. I can never quite remember.
You're a funny guy, Roy. Haven't I always said what a funny guy Roy is? And how much fun it will be to get together with him sometime. Oh,
wait, poor Johnny. He's the dark, sensitive type. He's a serviceman too, Cole. Johnny was in Okinawa.
You were in the crotch?
6th Marines.
The lieutenant who won the Silver Star up on Sugarloaf. I've heard of you.
Something like that.
All right, have we finished flirting? You got something to discuss, Roy? Are you going to stand around beating the meat while my lunch gets cold?
We have some questions.
Do I need my lawyer?
Your brother-in-law, Lenny Finkelstein, was selling stolen morphine. He had 1/3 of the shipment.
Old news, kid.
A waitress will be with you in a moment.
I don't know anything about what Lenny was up to.
So I'm supposed to believe that you don't know what happened to the rest of the shipment?
Lenny, God rest his soul, was a moron. He was family, though, and I haven't made a beef about that, so count yourself lucky, kid. The H is a filthy habit, and I don't condone it. The simple solution would be to have all the dope fiends put down.
So you don't know where he got the morphine?
Kid, ask a question you might get an answer to.
We believe there's a link between a group of Marines and the morphine stolen from the SS Coolidge. One of those Marines was shot to death in a club last night.
I wouldn't know anything about that.
So you haven't heard anything about what happened at the 111 Club?
What can I say, kid? I'm shocked that in the land of opportunity, Uncle Sam's finest feel the need to resort to crime. It's a dangerous business. I can attest to that. I'd recommend they get out of the life. Quickly.
A few Negroes saying goodbye on the sidewalk will never make the papers, Mickey. But we had a judge in Pasadena say adios the other day. Prominent white people popping their clogs makes everyone nervous.
You know dope has never been my thing, Roy. It's always been for schmendricks like Jack D and Jimmy Utley. But I'll ask around and I'll get back to you. Hey, you boys want some lunch? How about a drink?
We'll take a rain check on that. Come on, Cole, we're leaving.
We have to cut that dope. It looks bad with people dying.
We have to get the rest of it. There's no way of watering down the stuff in those little packages. You have to put the squeeze on those guys and get the rest of it.
They don't seem to type the fright that easy.
We'll see.
We missed something in that mess at the 111. Let's go back.
You're behind the wheel.
Do we know where we're going?
Well, you can only dream.
How well did you know the owner?
Goldrick? Well enough. He was in my unit.
That's some cruel irony. You survive the war, then get blown to pieces back home.
It happens more than you'd think. Young guys trying to adjust to normal life, getting mixed up in the wrong crowds.
The kid had just bought a nightclub. I'd say he got mixed up in the right crowds.
Until someone filled him full of holes.
You don't come into that kind of money that quickly without pissing a few people off.
You can drive.
Fine. Where are we headed?
You know the way. You can drive.
That's the cop from the newspaper.
Yeah, I'm thinking of moving up to a 45. I want to put him down in one round.
Isn't there anything
in California to be a secretary? Trying to imagine you with a personality.
because the bum took a swipe at me. Put him down with my sap.
We ran the light on Olympic, and we finally collared him on Temple.
I think his name is Phelps. I read about him in the paper.
Well, this day was a total waste of makeup.
Mouthpiece were stripped off me at the grand jury. Case got thrown out. Now the DA wants my head.
Can you drive to this one?
All right, where to?
Source, or is this coming from what's left in circulation? Brand new. Never fired. They haven't been degreased yet. We could check on the serial numbers.
Is this guy hunting for bear? Look at these things.
They're BARs. You get the odd guy who sneaks one of them home from the war. How did he get three of them? Army surplus morphine, army surplus weapons, army surplus valors. Sound familiar?
We should get back to the station and check the details of what exactly was lifted from that ship.
You drive. I need to go over the case notes.
Do we know where we're going? Stoker has gone public about Brenda.
Who is Brenda?
Brenda is LA's most famous madam.
And everyone knows it?
Of course everyone knows. Brenda pays her way.
Are we cops or a collection agency?
Whores have been around since the Bible. Our job is to keep it off the street so Joe Citizen and his wife can stroll around unmolested.
Then we should change the law.
Are you out of your mind? Every politician in America is against prostitution, except when they're using them.
So where does Stoker come in?
He objects to the LAPD and the administration taking its cut.
Is everyone in on this?
Yeah, and that's the problem. From a little acorn does a large tree grow. He could bring the whole thing crashing down on us.
Aren't you supposed to be working the...
Sir, do you know which robbery detectives are working the Army surplus theft from the Coolidge?
Caldwell and McManus. I saw Caldwell in the squad room not long ago, if you want to speak to him.
Thank you, sir. We'll do that.
This way.
I don't care. I don't go into letting games with that. That's cool. Are you going to
release me now? Harry, you got a minute?
Sure, Cole, anytime.
You've been working the docks robbery on the SS Coolidge?
Yeah, that's right. So how do you see it? Inside job. Either the guys working the wharves or some of the guys on the ship.
What else was taken apart from the morphine?
Case of BARs, case of Thompson's, Crate of Valor smokes.
Homicide just recovered 3 BARs and a mountain of cigarettes at a shooting at the 111 Club.
No kidding. I better get over there.
Do you have a copy of the manifest?
Yeah. Here it is.
Mouthpiece or strips off me.
So, how do we connect the docks robbery to the mess at the 111 Club?
Mouthpiece or strips off me at the grand jury. Case got thrown out. Now the DA wants my head. Mouthpiece or strips off me at the grand jury. Case got thrown out. Now the DA wants my head. Mouthpiece or strips off me at the
grand jury.
Enough
to arm three companies.
Now the DA wants my head.
Here's our backroom arsenal from the 111 Club.
Yeah, the bum took a swipe at me.
Half a million cigarettes loose on the streets of L.A. This is the crate we recovered. Some of these guys are from my old unit. They must have finally shipped home. Kelso, Sheldon, McGoldrick.
McGoldrick was on the boat?
Sure, we checked him out.
McGoldrick bought the 111 Club, Harry. His brains are all over the bar.
Looks like whoever stole the dope is getting muscled.
By whom?
Dragner or Cohen. They control the hop.
Detectives, KGPL's going crazy. Shots fired at 1384 North Bronson. Some guy with an automatic spraying a Hollywood bus. They want every car. Go!
This guy gave his wife a tap. I say all's fair in love and war. I say we bust in there and find the goddamn evidence.
Hey, I think there's bike force there.
You can drive.
Where are we going?
All units, officers need help at 1384 North Bronson. 1384 North Bronson, shots fired. Any units to handle identified. Code 3.
Thank you.
phone number and restaurant table. It's one of the BARs. Alvaro.
He's one of the guys from the ship?
His name was on the manifest.
Looks like McGoldrick wasn't the only one to get a message.
Hey, Alvaro.
Hey, Lieutenant.
He's just a plain detective now, Chico.
Who's the Jughead?
This is my partner, Roy Earl. We just want to find out what happened.
What happened is that someone took a shot at my bus. And then cops turned up and started treating me like I'm some sort of pachuco punk. My people have been in California for over 300 years.
Very fucking admirable, Felix.
You hear anything about the big heist on the Cool Ridge?
Yeah, I heard about it.
So what happened?
Not much. The cops came and interviewed me and all the other guys on the ship.
I was down at the 111 Club this morning, waiting for the medical examiner to scrape Eddie McGoldrick's brains off the bar. You want to tell me anything about that?
I heard that Eddie came into some money. Too bad he didn't keep a low profile. It was a tough break to get through Okinawa and then have to buy it back home.
Who's shooting at you, Felix?
How the fuck do I know?
The dead guy on the roof works for Mickey Cohen. Why would Cohen want you dead?
Man, I don't know anything about Mickey Cohen or any of those gangsters.
Your name was in the sniper's notebook. Level with me, Felix.
Cohen thinks because we were on the boat, we have the morphine. Courtney's meeting those guys to sort it out.
Courtney Sheldon?
Yeah. You remember Sheldon, don't you, Cole?
We'll be in touch, Felix.
You heard that Jack is in L.A.?
I saw his name on the manifest.
He's been here a couple of months. Sure glad to see you got over your wound, Lieutenant. I mean... Detective?
Pretty cool customer.
He's been under fire before.
You buying his story?
Not for a minute.
I got friends who work at the examiner. How about $5 for the exclusive?
Phelps, badge 1247.
How could I help, Detective?
I need an address on a Jack Kelso.
Just a second. Jack Kelso, apartment 4, 1408 North El Centro Avenue, Hollywood.
Thank you. You're behind the wheel.
Do we know where we're going?
Jack was a company sergeant. He would never get involved in something like this.
We brace him and drag him downtown.
It won't work. He's a tough customer. Jack. This is Detective Roy Earl.
Hello, Cole.
We would like a word.
Would you like to come inside?
Actually, we'd prefer if you'd come downtown with us. Do you mind?
Do I have any choice?
No. You don't.
Are you going to tell me what this is all about?
It would be better for all of us if we discussed it at the station.
Bad move, Cole.
How have you been, Jack?
Cut the crap. Pick me up in front of my apartment like a common criminal and then expect small talk? Fuck you.
know that there's a gang war going on in L.A. trying to recover that stolen morphine?
That has nothing to do with me.
I'm sure it would be gripping to hear more of your life story, boys, but the truth is, I don't give a fuck. You were on the boat, Kelso. What happened?
Do you really think a bunch of Marines could muscle in on the dope rackets in this town? Between the vice squad and the mob, I hear it's pretty sewn up.
You'd better watch your mouth.
Did you know that Eddie McGoldrick recently came into money and bought a nightclub?
No, I didn't know that.
Then you didn't know that some mobsters blew his brains out last night?
No, I didn't.
You heard that a crate of BARs went missing?
No, I didn't.
I saw Felix Alvaro today.
Good. How was he?
A little pale. One of Mickey Cohen's goons had emptied about 60 BAR rounds into the bus he was driving. A public bus, in the middle of Hollywood. Are you going to tell me what's going on? Or do more innocent people have to die?
Yeah, and what's in it for you, Cole? Newspapers? More glory? Another promotion? Another medal at the expense of men who fought for their country? Count me out.
What do you know about the Army surplus robbery from the Coolidge, Jack?
What I know is that on three separate occasions, you would have been dead if it weren't for me. I don't know anything about the robbery.
People are dying because morphine, intended to help servicemen, is being used on the street. Now we have guys from our old unit being killed by mobsters. We can put two and two together, Jack.
Gratitude isn't a concept that has much effect on you, is it, Cole?
Answer the question, Jack. Let's get this over with.
I was interviewed when the robbery took place. I don't have anything further to add.
Jack, just want information.
Bullshit, Cole. Did you seriously believe that dragging me down here would get me to give up my own guys? You call yourself a Marine? Trying to make a name for yourself with this shitheel? Look at this chump with his $200 suit and $2,000 car.
The tough guy act is really impressive. I like you, Jack. I'd like to make you for this. I really would. I'm gonna be working on it and keeping an eye on you. You can go now.
Shooting, Robert Steiner, 6780 West Sunset Boulevard. The victim is a Chris Majewski.
Another name from the manifest?
How many more friends of yours are gonna get plugged today?
Talk about tension. That was like being trapped in an elevator with a married couple who can't decide whether they love each other or hate each other.
We go back a long way.
You went too easy on him. Next time, you leave it to me. I know how to handle that smug son of a bitch.
You don't. Jack will never give up his own men.
He just walked up and shot the man. Two of them officers, they went that way.
Go on, get after him.
I can't hit a target that isn't there, Phelps. Get in close and steer him off the tar. It's no good. We need to get closer. Hit him. Clear this asshole off the road. I can't take the shot from here, Cole. Step on it, huh? Just get me a little closer.
an LAPD file. We have a traitor in our midst. All of the names on the list have a hit team assigned to them.
We need to get to those guys fast, otherwise there'll be no case.
Bueno chavales, pues voy a cortar ya aquí. Espero que os haya gustado el vídeo. Like, favorito, suscribíos y hasta la próxima. Adiós.